The real-time crime center is bigger than Baton Rouge. This is for all first responders in East Baton Rouge Parish, our firefighters, our EMS, Louisiana State Police, our federal partners, Zachary PD, Baker Police Department, LSU, Baton Rouge Community College, Southern University. Every law enforcement agency, including Central, will be part and will have access to the real-time crime center.
There was a day and time when agencies didn't talk, much less talk to each other. Most gratifying thing to me in law enforcement and being a sheriff of East Baton Rouge Parish is seeing that so many of those walls have been torn down. And I think one of the things that's helped us tear down those walls was two things. Number one, the public demands that we work together now. They demand that we cooperate with each other, and the demands on law enforcement dictate that as well. We have to communicate with each other. We have to work together on a daily basis. But I think technology has played a big part in bringing that together as well.
Our community residents all want to live in a place that they feel safe in. They want to be able to go to their homes, travel in the community, and feel safe. And so what this real-time crime center will do, it will certainly elevate the efficiency and effectiveness of our law enforcement, but it will also respond to the needs of citizens who want to have a safe community.
We hope to put together all of the and use different cameras that citizens have, but tie that in not only with those cameras, but with ShotSpotter technology, with the Crime Strategies Unit, with license plate readers.
If we can tie in everyone's cameras from whether it be a business or a residence and tie it into the real-time crime center, we can see car burglaries occurring in residents in real time. We're not getting the video that people have after it's already occurred, and it allows us to send units to address that problem right then and there.
Once the community sees that we are investing in this infrastructure here, they're going to also continue to cooperate more as they have in the recent past. And this is going to all about community cooperation.
The bad actors that we have to deal with on a daily basis, that small group of people that we believe are responsible for majority of the crimes, they can care less about jurisdictional lines. The real-time crime center allows us to access information that we wouldn't normally have access to.
The real-time crime center will add value to law enforcement, but it will also help to close the gap between the community and law enforcement by providing accurate information, data, being data driven, and allowing accuracy in policing. Certainly we recognize that if we're going to have a 21st century police department, that technology and data has to be at the forefront. So this real-time crime center will be a game changer for the overall landscape of policing in our community.